Danny Rand is the Iron Fist. By plunging his hand into the molten heart of a dragon, he gained the ability to focus his energy, his chi, into it. This gives his hand a supernatural yellow glow, and the ability to strike with superhuman hardness and impact whilst being impervious to pain or injury. But is there a way that he and you could gain that same yellow glow with real hard science and not the mystic arts?
Now, when I see something glowing, I immediately think, that's hot. That's because hot objects emit a spectrum of light based solely on their temperature. From the overall color of the light they emit, you can actually work out how hot they are, their color temperature. We do this for stars all the time. However, unfortunately, the pure yellow of Iron Fist's hand isn't on the Planckian locus. That's the path through all possible colours that hot bodies take as their temperatures ramp up. The closest thing to yellow is at about 3000 Kelvin with this light orange colour. But having a 3000 Kelvin hand would not be good for you. Remember, you're 70% water, and that of course evaporates at a mere 100 degrees C. At 300 degrees C, your flesh would start to combust, and by 1700 degrees C, you're at the temperature of most crematoriums. Basically, most of your hand would have vaporized, and anything left would either be ash or bone. Thankfully, there is another way.
Luminescence is the name for any light emitted not from heat. In most of its many, many forms, it works by exciting an atom or molecule to a higher energy level than usual. Now, nature is inherently lazy. It likes to go back down to a lower energy level, the lowest possible one. Well, how does it do this? It can emit a packet of energy, a photon of light. Thanks to quantum mechanics, every substance has its own set of possible energy levels that it can occupy. And therefore, every possible transition from higher to lower energy levels, or every possible photon that you can emit, is a unique fingerprint for that substance. In other words, different materials emit different colors of light. But this whole luminescent process requires energy to be input in the first place to excite the atoms or molecules. And that energy can come from lots of different places, such as higher frequency, more energetic light, like UV, forms of ionizing radiation, electricity, or what's most useful for our purposes, chemical reactions. Certain reactions produce molecules in excited states, which will then give out light when they relax. This is what happens inside a glow stick, so remember that the next time you're at a 90s rave. Now, these reactions also occur within some organisms, where it's called bioluminescence. Most of those creatures can be found in the ocean, with a few exceptions. These organisms create a pigment called luciferin, which, yes, is named after Lucifer, but not that Lucifer, it's Latin for lightbringer, just to make things nice and confusing. Luciferin reacts with oxygen, helped along by the enzyme luciferase, using some quantum biological magic, to produce light and a whole load of other products. That light is used by the creatures for communication, attraction, defense, even camouflage. Bioluminescent light is a cold light, meaning less than 20% of the energy goes to heat, which is definitely good for Danny and us. But can we produce that yellow glow that we're after? Well, nature has shown a plethora of colors which can be produced in this process, from blues, greens, reds, and yes, the yellow glow of fireflies. No, not that firefly, this one. What controls the color of that bioluminescent light is the structure of the luciferin molecules. And it turns out changing just one amino acid is enough to give you almost any color you like. In fact, we've been able to splice the genes that create this light-producing pigment into other things, mostly plants, to make them slightly glow. So while Danny may say he plunged his hand into the heart of a dragon, I reckon he actually got genetically modified to produce light-producing pigments in his hand. That gives him the ability to emit a strange yellow glow that probably scares the sh** out of most people. And it's a good thing Danny is a nice guy, because with that sort of eerie powers, he could probably rule New York with... what's that phrase again? Thank you so much for watching all of this Iron Fist video. I really do appreciate it. I would also appreciate any likes, shares, or subscribes you'd like to give to me, and I'll see you on my next video.